What is the world's greatest resource? Some say oil and minerals, but we'll run out of those soon. What about wind and water? They're tough to harness. At the end of the day, nature's gifts need the human touch. So we humans are the most important resource in the world, you could say. But that resource is a double-edged sword. Having a young, healthy population is one thing. Finding them work and making them productive is another, and a lot more difficult. Our youth can drive us down two roads, demographic dividend or demographic disaster. For the moment, let's focus on avoiding that disaster. How do you do that? By skilling our youth, by getting them ready for the job market. We have a whole day dedicated to this process, and that's today, July 15th, World Youth Skills Day. The idea is to make our youth understand the importance of skills, how skills will help them choose the right job and thus help them thrive. Let's start by understanding what we mean by a skill. What is a skill? I'll give you a basic definition. A skill is the ability that you need in order to do a job or activity. As simple as that. Some skills are innate. Well, not everyone can drive a Formula One car or play World Cup cricket. But some skills can be taught. And World Youth Skills Day focuses on these skills, the ones that can be taught. For India, skill development is not an option. It is a necessity. Today, Prime Minister Narendra Modi unveiled 75 new skilling programs. He said youth skills are the foundation of a self-sufficient India. And he's right, but the challenge is daunting. By 2030, India will have the world's largest working age population. 65% of the people will be working or seeking jobs. That's nearly 1 billion people, 1 billion people in the job market. The possibilities are many. But will Indian youth be ready for this job market? How is the prep work going? In many ways, this decade will be crucial. Experts say it is India's last chance to extract a demographic dividend. But the problem is, skills are not singular. There are millions of skills out there. Our job is to find the right fit for us. And this is where schools come in. This is where schools are important. Catch them early. That must be the strategy. If skilling is part of schools, we can identify each student's aptitude, what they're good at, what they enjoy doing, and that's half the job done. Instead, our schools overload students with information, all data, no specialization, that's what they give. And when these students enter the job market, things are the exact opposite. 90% of jobs today need a specific set of skills. In contrast, 20% of our graduates end up jobless. Clearly, there's something wrong with the system. We churn out jacks of all trade, but they're masters of none. How can we change this? It starts with legislation. Skilled faculty must be introduced at schools, along with skilling classes to test aptitude. India has dozens of skill development programs. They're all well budgeted and well marketed, but they start too late. There's also no denying that attitude needs to change. Skills are frowned upon in most parts of the world. Very few people understand dignity of labor, especially here in India. There are more naysayers than jobs nowadays. But remember, you work for yourself, not for the society. Well, you should eventually, but initially you should work for yourself to sustain yourself. Once you realize the power of skilling, you move to the next step, identifying which skill to pursue. And that depends on two things, your interest and the job market. Today, the job market is heavily influenced by the pandemic. The World Economic Forum says more than 1 billion jobs will be transformed by technology. That's almost one third of all jobs worldwide. So the pandemic legacy will shape our skills. According to LinkedIn, these are the five fastest emerging jobs in India: blockchain developer, artificial intelligence specialist, JavaScript developer, robotics consultant, and back-end developer. What is common in all these five jobs? Cutting-edge technology and specialization. That's where we're heading. A world of cutthroat competition, degrees by themselves will not be enough. Neither will skills alone. What will help you are rare attributes, things that will set you apart from the competition, like leadership, initiative, ingenuity. These can be cultivated from your days in school, and those improve your stock in the job market. Of course, all of this will amount to nothing if governments cannot create jobs. And that depends on skilled politicians. Beyond your control, yes, but equally consequential. VEON is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.